Iran's announcement that its sights are set on advanced flanker variants like the Su-30SM is another indication of how dire the unfolding geopolitical situation is in Southwest Asia and the Middle East, especially given the lackluster response by our own country to Iran's predictable yet emboldened saber-rattling. All that cash which has been freed up by poor decision-making will end up paying for these jets, as well as other systems that will pose a formidable threat to anyone opposing Iran's objectives. Iran looks set to sign a deal to purchase Russian-made Sukhoi Su-30 Flanker fighters as it upgrades its military forces following the nuclear deal, which cleared the way for sanctions to be lifted on Tehran. Iranian Defense Minister Brig. Gen. Hossein Dehgan is set to visit Moscow on February 16 to discuss the potential fighter buy, as well as to discuss deliveries of the Almaz anti-S-300 air and missile defense system. Minister Dehgan will also discuss the delivery of Su-30 airplanes because the defense ministry believes the Iranian Air Force needs this type of plane. We've moved far in these discussions of purchases, and I think that during the upcoming visit, a contract will be signed, an Iranian Defense Ministry source told the Russian state-run media outlet Sputnik. Earlier, the Iranian Mehr News Agency had quoted Dehgan, who appeared on Iranian state TV, saying that Tehran needs to focus on modernizing its air force. To that end, Dehgan specifically cited the Su-30, but he did not indicate which version of Russian-built jet Tehran is interested in. Today we need to pay attention to air force and aircraft, and we seek to seal a deal with the Russians, upon which we will have partnership in the construction and manufacturing of the jet fighter, Dehgan said. Presumably Iran would want one of the advanced variants similar to the aircraft operated by India, Malaysia, Algeria and Russia itself. However, it is also possible that Iran could opt for a variant of the more basic Su-30M2, which is also in service with the Russian Air Force. That variant is somewhat less expensive, which might make more sense considering Iran's economic situation. Perhaps of note, Iran does not seem content with merely buying the Su-30, Tehran seems intent on license production of the aircraft. The Su-30M2 variant, which is built in Komsomolsk-on-Amur in Russia's Far East, is missing the Su-30SMS canards and thrust vectoring nozzles. It also has a less comprehensive avionics suite. Either way, the addition of any Su-30 variant would greatly increase the capabilities of the Iranian Air Force, which is mostly equipped with an antiquated mix of American, Russian and Chinese-built hardware. Russia has also offered to license produce the third-generation T-90 main battle tank in Iran. Under the so-called Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action, JCPOA, an international agreement on the nuclear program of Iran signed in July 2015, the UN arms embargo will be lifted 5 years after the JCPOA adoption day. However, conventional weapons sales can be decided on a case-by-case basis, meanwhile I explained earlier in the year. The Su-30SM is based on the Su-30MKI export version, an aircraft jointly developed by Russia with Hindustan Aeronautics Limited for the Indian Air Force. However, the two-seat SM is a localized variant of the MKI, and unlike the latter, does not contain Israeli and French avionics. It retains, however, the same airframe made of titanium and high-strength aluminum alloys, and also features the MKI's AL-37FP thrust vectoring engines, among other things. However, already in April a senior U.S. official testified that the United States would block any sale of Russian combat aircraft to Iran. "We would block the approval of fighter aircraft," Thomas Shannon, the U.S. Undersecretary of State for Political Affairs, said. "We've got a commitment from the Russians in terms of working to prohibit the transfer of technologies to Iran's ballistic missile program," Shannon added.